Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Good morning, children. Welcome to the online education of PTK Higher Secondary School. And today we are doing social study of 10th standard, and we continue the same chapter, economic development. In economic development, we have seen different topics like, you know, economic activities, non-economic activities, the factor of production and the distribution of factors of production, and yes, of course, market system. So up to this point we have seen. Now today we are doing socialist system of economy. You know, in past, there were countries like China and Russia who adopted socialist system of economy, and they made fast economic development in their country. So what is this system? Why it was implemented by the countries like China and Russia? That we have to see today. Socialistic system of economy is completely opposite to the market system. And when in 1929, when we see the failure in market system in America, especially when we saw the great recession which took place in America in 1929, after that, you know, some countries refused to accept the market system in their country, and as a result, socialistic system of economy came into existence. Now what is this socialistic system of economy? It is very easy. In this type of economy, the government holds the ownership of all economic activities. The government holds the ownership of all industries in country. Private sector is not allowed. Nobody can make investment, nobody can start any industry. But only the government, only the state can make the investment, only they can start industries where people can work, they can earn salary, but they cannot be able to have the ownership of any resource or ownership of any industry. This is what socialistic system of economy. And unlike market system, where profit is at the center of all economic activity, here in socialistic system of economy, profit does not have got any importance, but social welfare is at the center of socialistic economy. Let us see some of the great features. The first one is the resources owned by government. All resources are owned by government only. All industries ownership, it belongs to government only. As I told you, private sector is not allowed. If anybody wants to start a business in market system, it is easily possible, because there is a free entry. But in socialistic system, person's entry in production or in establishment of industry is completely restricted by the government. Second, economic decisions taken by government only. As government is the owner of all resources, as government is owner of all industries, so all economic decisions are taken by government only. People cannot interfere in taking economic decisions. Well, what we have to produce, how we have to produce, which thing we have to produce, everything is decided by government only. Which resources of production, which factors of production we have to use, that is to be decided by government. And government actually starts industry, establishes industry as per the need of the society, as per the need of the people. In this type of economy, the production of luxurious goods are avoided. Okay, luxurious goods like, you know, the branded watches, the branded cars, the branded products, you know, are avoided. But what is needed, what is more useful for the survival of the people, that is very important in this type of economy. And as I told you, social welfare is at the center. The government does not want to earn maximum profit. But what is the attitude of government? What is the purpose of government? The purpose of government is to provide good quality of product at very reasonable rate to the people of country. So that is social welfare. And in this type of economy, in this type of socialist system, people can work. People can work as a labor. They will get wages by the government, but they cannot be the owners. For example, in India, people have got their own land. They are the owners, and whatever they want to do, whatever crop they want to do agriculture of, they are free. If they want to cultivate wheat, if they want to do the agriculture of vegetables, they are free. But in socialistic system, well, everything is decided by government only. If government asks the farmers to do the agriculture of wheat, in that case, they have to produce wheat only. No other food grain can be produced by the farmers. So these are the attractive features of socialistic economy. And after this, we have to see the benefits and limitations of socialistic system. Let us focus on the benefits. Why Russia and China in past they adopted socialistic economy? So let us see the first one. What is required to society is manufactured. Well, the country, the state or the government produces the goods as per the need of the society. If suppose right now there is a demand of food grain, in that case, everywhere in the country, well, the entire focus will be there on the production of food grain only. If there is a demand of cloth, in that case, all industries will produce what? Clothes only. So this is at the center. So because of this, what happens, there is no scarcity of the commodity created in the market. And everything is available in the market at very reasonable rate. And with the help of this, people can satisfy their wants very cheaply. Second, wastage of the resource is not possible. Yeah, we all know that natural resources are limited. They are very precious. They should be used, they should be utilized judiciously, rationally. Okay? As all the ownership of all the resources belongs to government only. Government is the owner of all the resources. So government makes it sure that the wastage must not be there of any resource. They use all the resources with minimum wastage. And that is great actually. Okay. Third is disparity of income not possible. Yeah. The gap between the richness and poverty cannot be seen in socialistic system of economy. We saw in the market system that rich people become richer, poor gets poorer. But in this type of economy, what happens? Equality is there in the country. All people are labor. They earn their salary as per their talent, as per their skill. They cannot be the owners. So as equality is there in income, disparity of income cannot be seen in socialistic system. And the fourth and the most important benefit is what? Exploitation of consumer is not possible. When exploitation comes into existence? Well, when any person wants to get maximum profit, at that time the person does not get hesitated in cheating the customer, in cheating consumer, in doing exploitation of the consumer, right? But here, the main purpose of socialistic economy is what? The social welfare. The government does not want to have any profit, okay? So, they provide good quality of commodity at very reasonable rate, and that's why exploitation of customer is not possible. Customer and consumer, two different words are there. Let me explain you the difference between the customer and consumer. Customer means the person who purchases a good from the market, right? That is called who? Customer. If suppose you have gone to shop, you have purchased a pen, in that case you are a customer. Now what is consumer? Consumer means the person who uses the product, who uses any product to satisfy his want. That person is called who? Consumer. For example, your daddy has purchased bike for you, right? So your daddy is a customer, but who is going to use the bike? Who is the user of bike? You. So you are consumer. Understood the difference between customer and consumer? I hope you have understood. So after seeing the benefits of socialistic economy, we have to focus on the limitation. Well, today, you know, the countries who adopted socialistic system, China and Russia, they have left this type of economy, okay? Why? Just because of the limitation of socialistic economy. And see the first one, zero encouragement to public in production. People are not the owners, they are laborers, they are workers, they earn salary, right? As they earn salary, they are satisfied with that much only. And they are not interested in doing any research work. They are not interested in increasing the production of any commodity. Why? Because they will not get any additional benefit. And because of that, lack of motivation is found in socialistic economy. No motivation, no encouragement is given to research or in the invention of any technology or any machinery. Second, low ratio of research. Yeah, the government's focus is to just satisfy the needs of the people. And profit is not at the center, right? So because of that, the state or the government does not spend any extra money for the research of any technology or any machine. Third, no individual freedom. In the greatest limitation of socialistic economy, that freedom is not given to private sector. Freedom is not given to the people. Okay, they cannot start industry. They can work only as a labor. And the fourth one, fear of bureaucracy. Well, whenever the government holds the entire power, right? The government owns the entire power on all resources, on all factors of production, chances of bureaucracy increases. They become dictators. And ultimately, people have to suffer a lot in this type of economy. So this is socialistic system of economy. Three important points: features, benefits, and limitation. Hoping that you all have understood this.